हेलो स्टूडेंट, इन टुडे सेशन ऑफ एडवांस फॉर्मिंग एंड जॉइनिंग प्रोसेस वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द इलेक्ट्रो हाइड्रोलिक फॉर्मिंग एंड इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक फॉर्मिंग. ओके, एज इलेक्ट्रो फॉर्म हाइड्रोलिक फॉर्मिंग इज सिमिलर टू दैट ऑफ द हाइड्रो फॉर्मिंग. इन हाइड्रो फॉर्मिंग वी यूज अ वॉटर और वी यूज अ प्रेशर ऑफ द वॉटर टू डिफॉर्म द मटेरियल और यूज अ वॉटर प्रेशर फॉर अ फॉर्मिंग ऑपरेशन. सिमिलरली इन इलेक्ट्रो hydraulic forming we will use the same principle, but the pressure that build on a water is due to the electric discharge. Okay, so in today's session we will discussing these two processes, that is electro hydraulic forming and electromagnetic forming, in which we will discuss about the introduction of each process, process principle, what is the principle behind that processes, constructional details, advantages and disadvantages, and then the applications. Okay, so introduction. In these processes the large amount of energy is applied in a short interval of the time. As the forming process, the impact energy is necessary for a forming operation. The impact forces is necessary, and this impact force is produced in a very short time, and that's why in this processes the large amount of energy will be applied on the workpiece with a very short of time or a short interval of the time. These processes are useful to deform the material like titanium, tungsten alloy under high strain rate. Means if we consider the hardness of the tungsten or titanium is high, so these processes are used for the such type of the material. The parts are formed at the rapid rate, and thus these processes are also called as the high velocity forming process. Means the rate of forming is very high, that's why it is also called as the high velocity forming process. There are several advantages of these processes. What are the advantages of these processes? Like a die cost is low, the cost of the die which is low in this process, easy maintenance of tolerances. The tolerances we require to maintain, which can be easily maintained in this process. Possibility of the forming the most of the metal. Most of the metal can be formed by using these processes. Material does not show the spring back effect. The material will not show the spring back effect. The production cost of the component by such processes is the low. Means the production cost which is required to produce the parts is low in this type of the processes. And what is the limitation of this process is that skilled personnel is required. The skilled person is required for these processes. So we will discuss one by one. The first one is the electro-hydraulic forming, which is also known as the electro-discharge or electro-shape or electro-spark forming. Electro-discharge means discharge of the electric current. Electro shape means electric current is used to shape the object, or electro spark means spark that produced due to the electricity will be used in this forming process. Process principle. What is the principle on which this electrohydraulic process will work? Electrohydraulic forming tool and processes produce a shock wave. The shock waves, as we discussed, that impact forces is necessary for a forming operation. So here they use the word shock waves by creating a high voltage discharge in a liquid. These create the high velocity, or they produce the shock wave in a liquid with a high voltage discharge. Due to the discharge of the high voltage, the shock waves are produced inside the liquid that is in a contact with the sheet, and this liquid is in a contact with the blank or a metal sheet which we need to deform. Okay, so the shock wave are produced inside the liquid due to high voltage discharge. The shock wave that produced is due to the high voltage discharge in a liquid, and this liquid is in a contact with the metal sheet or a blank, and this due to this shock wave, the metal or material gets deformed. The shock wave in a liquid is propagated towards the blank and causes the blank to deform. Due to this shock wave, the liquid will deform and liquid will propagate, and this liquid will apply the pressure on a sheet metal, and this sheet metal get deform, and this sheet metal will deform into an open die that has a forming surfaces. Okay, the shock wave forces the blank into the engagement with the forming surface to form the metal blank into the desired shape. Means due to this shock wave, the blank get engagement with the forming surface. Means due to this shock wave, the metal sheet take the shape of the die. Due to this shock wave, this metal sheet will be a move, or it will be a deform into the required shape of the die, and this metal shape will get the required shape. Constructional details of and working. A typical configuration of EHF electrohydraulic forming include, means which things are needed for electrohydraulic forming is, the one is a form includes the discharge chamber, electrodes, forming die and pulse generator, which consists of a high voltage inductive bank of capacitor. High voltage inductive bank capacitor are needed to produce the shock wave. A high voltage current discharge switch, the switch is necessary, and charging and amplifying the rectifying the circuit in illustrated in a figure 1. The capacitor bank is capable of producing a discharge of 5 to 25 kilowatt. Yeah. The capacity of the capacitor bank to produce the discharge of 5 to 25 kilovolt and can store the energy up to the 100 kilojoule. Means it can, the capacitor bank has a capacity to produce the discharge of 5 to 25 kilowatt. This amount of the voltage should be produced by the capacitor bank, and it can be stored the energy up to 100 kilojoule. The energy stored, or the amount of energy need to store by the capacitor bank should be a 100 kilojoule. Means this much amount of capacitor bank is necessary. The sheet metal blank is placed on the top of the discharge chamber. Means this at the top discharge chamber, at the top of the discharge chamber, the sheet metal get placed. One side of the die is positioned at the above bank. Means on one side of the sheet metal, the die will be placed so that the sheet metal will take the shape of that die. After the air is evacuated from both the sides of the blank, means the air should be removed from the both the sides of the die, because if the air is compressed between the die and the blank, and when shock waves if the air is present between the die and the blank, this air will be compressed due to the shock wave, and in absence of the shock wave, this compressed air will again expand, and it will show the spring back effect in a material. So the material that deformed due to the shock wave will comes to its original shape due to the this compressed air. So the air should be removed from the both the sides of the die. After the air is evacuated from the both the sides of the blank, the chamber is filled with the water. The water should be present in it, the fully emerging electrode. See, this is the arrangement. This is our capacitor bank that is produce the pulse generation. Here is water. These two are the electrode. Water is filled inside here. The air is removed from the die. Okay, this is our die upper shape. This is our blank. Here is our blank. This blue color show the water. These are the electrode and air. See here, the air is removed from this die cavity. Okay, when we switch on the switch, then high voltage will be produced here, and due to this high voltage, the shock wave will produce, and due to this shock wave, the water here means the shock wave is produced at that place here, and when this shock wave is propagated through the water, it will display this or displace this blank. Means the shock wave here will be displaced and will propagate, and it will displace this blank, and this blank will take the shape of this die. The blank will take the shape of the die. Okay, and this is the principle behind the electrohydraulic forming. See here, the formation can be controlled by applying the external resistance in the form of die, or by varying the amount of energy release. Okay, means if we see if here is electrode, or here the shock wave will produce, and this shock wave will propagate in all the direction uniformly, and due to this die cavity, this blank will take the shape of this die cavity. Okay, now process parameter. Which are the process parameter that should be a consider in the electrohydraulic forming? The standoff distance. The standoff distance means the distance from the electrode, or a distance from the blank to where the shock wave will propagate. Means the starting point of the shock wave to the distance up to the blank is called as the standoff distance. It should be a optimum, means it should not be a very large, or it should be not very small. It should be optimum, and this optimum distance is calculated by the experimentally. Okay, this distance, optimum distance, standoff distance will be calculated by the experimentally. Now capacitor use. Capacitor that used for this process, this is the one process parameter. The energy of the pressure pulse depend on the size of the capacitor, means what amount of energy will produce, or the intensity of the shock wave will depend on the size of the capacitor. Transfer medium means the energy is produced due to the shock wave, and this energy is transferred up to the sheet metal is called as the transfer medium. Generally water is used, but in cases we can use the inert gases also, but generally water is used as a transfer medium. Vacuum, the die cavity must be evacuated to prevent the adiabatic heating of the workpiece due to the sudden compression of the air. Means if the air is not removed from the die cavity, the air inside the die cavity will compress, and it will show the effect of adiabatic heating. And due to this effect, sudden the spring back effect of the material will be a show. So the air should be removed from the die cavity. The material formed. Which type of the material can be a formed? The material having a low ductility or having a critical impact velocity less than 30 meter per second are generally not considered to the good. Means this is a material property. All the material that can be formed by a conventional forming processes can be formed by the EHF. Means the material which can be formed by the conventional forming, that is by press forming or by rolling or any other forming operation, can be formed easily by the electrohydraulic forming. These material are aluminium alloy, nickel alloy, stainless steel, titanium, inconel, etc. These are the materials that are formed by this process. Advantages and disadvantages. What are the advantages of electrohydraulic forming? The first advantage is electrohydraulic forming can form hollow shape with much ease and at less cost compared to the other forming techniques. Means the hollow shape that we required can be easily formed by this process, and the cost required for this process is less as compared to the other forming processes. The cost required for this process is less as other forming processes, but the single step process, it is a single step process. Means in a forming operation we required, if we consider a deep drawing operation in which we require the number of strokes as per depend on the height to diameter ratio. But here this electrohydraulic forming is a single step process, means the final component will be formed in a single step only, no other steps will required here. Enable extremely deep forming. Fine details and the sharp lines can be easily formed. Means sharp line or fine details. Means the product will be formed is the finely very fine. Forming of the male and female shape. Male and female shape can be easily formed. Means negative and positive parts. The process does not depend on the electrical properties of the work material. Means if the we using a two different metal or a material for a forming operation which having a different electrical property, but the shape or the process, this does not depend on the electrical property of the base material or a blank. Means if the blank having a different electrical property, it will not affect on the process. Okay, this will be the same for the both the material. Safer in handling than the explosive materials. Means in explosive forming we use explosive material to produce the shock wave, and to handle the explosive material is difficult. But in a case of electrohydraulic forming, such type of the explosive material no need to handle, so it is safer than the explosive forming process. Okay, disadvantages. What are the disadvantages of this process? The suitable only for a small works. It is suitable for a small works. Need for the vacuum makes the equipment more complicated. Means we need to remove the air from the die cavity. Means we maintain the vacuum there, and this process, or due to removal of air from the die cavity, it make the process complicated. The proper SOD is necessary to effective process. Means standoff distance should be a proper. If the standoff distance will if not proper, then process will not give the proper result, or the process will not produce the desired part as per our requirement, or we required a more input power for this purpose. If this SOD is not maintained properly, each discharge of the electrode can create a high voltage discharge in a fluid, result in a formation of impurities in the water. As high voltage is produced inside the water, and due to this shock wave, the impurities are produced inside the water. that result in evaporation of the electrode and maybe create the surface defects in the surface of the parts. Means due to this impurity, the shape or surface of the formed part get affected. The fluid in a vessel generally must be drained and replaced for each tool cycle. Means for each process, the water which is used in an electrohydraulic forming should need to replace. The volume of the fluid in the vessel for a larger part tends to be a fairly sustainable and considerable portion of the cycle time and tool dedicated draining and refilling of the vessel. Means to fill the water, to drain the water, here the time will be required for this process is high. So this is the disadvantage of this process. The application, what are the application of this process is, it includes the smaller radar dish, cone and other shapes in a thin and the small works, reduction of capital investment for a low volume and aerospace application, in automobile sector such as inside the component of the passenger and the car door, miniature and fancy equipment having the complicated profile of the electronic industry, etc. So these are the applications. Now we will discuss about the electromagnetic forming. As in electro discharge forming, electric energy is used. Here electrical and the magnetic effect will be used for forming operation. So what is the process principle in this process? This process is based on a principle stated by Lorentz force law. Means this process is depends on the Lorentz force law. That the what is this law? The magnetic field of the induced current always oppose the magnetic field on the induced current. What is the law? This, the magnetic field of induced current always oppose the electromagnetic field. Electromagnetic field on a induced current means the electromagnetic field which is produced or induced the current will oppose the electromagnetic field of the inducing current. See here, there are two different terms, induced current and inducing current. These are the two different terms. In this method, large capacitor bank is discharged, means the capacitor bank which hold the voltage will discharge to producing a high current through the coil inductor. Means this high current will discharge in a coil conductor. If the coil has been placed within the conductive cylinder, if this coil is placed in within the conductive cylinder, around the cylinder or adjust the flat sheet metal, then discharge induce the secondary current. Means if we gives the high voltage to the inductive current, then that will produce the secondary current into the workpiece. This secondary current further causes the repel from the coil and confirm the die and mating the workpiece. The process is very rapid and use the preliminary to expand or to contract the tubing or permanently assemble of the component. We will show what is this process here, the constructional details and working. The setup of electromagnetic forming consists of a pulse power generator. What things we required for this process is the pulse power generator, the inductor inducing the field shaper if applicable, the workpiece and application dependent further tool components such as the forming defining die. I mean die is necessary, then high pulse power generator is necessary, inductor inducing the field shape is necessary. So these things are necessary for this process. The process started by charging and subsequently discharging the capacitor. What is the first step in these processes? We need to charge the capacitor so it can be hold the voltage, and after that we need to discharge it for a pulse power generator. To produce the pulse power generator, then capacitor will be discharged. A sinusoidal current flows through the inductor. The current which flows through the inductor these current induce the corresponding magnetic field. As this current is passed through the inductor, then it will be produce the magnetic field. This will produce the magnetic field. If there is an electrically conductive workpiece in a direct proximity to the inductor, then a second oppositely directed current is induced. Due to the current induced in a magnet or due to the current in an inductor will produce the magnetic field, then due to the conductive workpiece which is directly in a proximity with the inductor, second oppositely direct current will be induced. The secondary current will be induced in a workpiece. The energy density stored in a magnetic field between a workpiece and an inductor. See here, the energy density stored in a magnetic field, that energy which stored in a magnetic field between a workpiece and an inductor acts as a magnetic pressure. Due to this energy store, this energy will be acts as a magnetic pressure which can reach the several hundreds of the megapascal. Means due to this magnetic pressure which will produce the several hundred megapascal pressure and causes the acceleration and deformation of the workpiece. Due to this stored magnetic pressure, thousands of megapascal of current will be produced and this will accelerate or deform the workpiece. The direction of movement is always tangented away from the inductor. Okay, see here, before forming, after forming. Depending on the geometry and the alignment of the tool and the workpiece, three process variant can be a discontinuous these. See here, electromagnetic compression of the tube and hollow profile by means of the inductor enclosing the workpiece. Means this type of the workpiece can be formed by using this magnetic electromagnetic forming. Electromagnetic expansion of the tube. See here, means here compression of the tube will be done and here expansion of the tube will be done. Means to do the compression of the tube should be around the workpiece, and to do the expansion of the tube is this coil should be inside the tube. So this, in this way, magnetic field or electromagnetic forming will be a work. See here, electromagnetic sheet forming for which inductor is positioned close proximity of the flat or semi finished part perform the component. Means if we want to produce such type of the component, then coil should be placed here and due to this magnetic pressure the sheet metal get deformed. What are the process parameter in this process that we will discuss here? So workpiece thickness, the thickness of the workpiece will be affect or this will should be a consider for the this pro, while doing this process. Means as the thickness of the workpiece changes, according to this other process parameter will also need to change. Then electrical conductivity in electro hydraulic forming, the electric conductivity of the workpiece will not affect on the process parameter, but in a electromagnetic forming, electric conductivity of the material will be affects on here. The higher the electric conductivity of the workpiece, the better the shielding of the magnetic field, the pressure difference is higher. Means electric conductivity of the workpiece or a blank will be a significantly affect on the process parameter. Then frequency, the higher frequency of the discharge current can be a balance a low conductivity of the small thickness. Means the frequency of the current will be also affect on it. Size of the capacitor bank, size of the capacitor bank is necessary. If the size of the capacitor bank is high, then high magnetic pressure will be produced. If the size of the capacitor bank is low, then it produces the small or it will be produced the low magnetic pressure. The strength of the current which decide the strength of the magnetic field and the force applied. obviously this if the strength of the current is high, then it will be decide the strength of the magnetic field, and it will also affect the force applied. Gap between the workpiece and the tool coil means the gap between the workpiece and the tool coil, it will be also affect. The smaller the air gap, higher the magnetic field and the pressure. If the gap is less, then higher magnetic field will be produced and higher magnetic pressure will be produced, and the parts get easily deformed. Winding of the tool coil, winding inner tool coil will also affect on the processes. For each pulse generator and each forming task exists an optimum number of turns. Okay, so these are the some process parameter of the electromagnetic forming. Now, advantages and disadvantages of this electromagnetic forming. So first one is the suitable for small tubes. This process is suitable only for small tubes. Operation like collapsing, bending and crimping can be easily done. To perform such types of the operation, that is collapsing, bending, crimping, the electromagnetic forming will be used. Electrical energy applied can be precisely controlled, and hence the process is accurately controlled. Means as the electric energy will control, this will control the process parameter. So this process can easily control. The process is safer as compared to the explosive forming. This process is safer as we compare it the explosive forming. Wide range of the application. It has a wide range of the application. Disadvantages is what are the disadvantages of this process is applicable only for electric conducting material. Means the material which are electrically conductor, only that material will be deformed by using this electromagnetic forming. Otherwise, the material which are not electric conductor, then it will be not deformed by this process. Not suitable for large work pieces. This process will be not suitable for the large work piece. It is suitable only for a small work piece. Rigid clamping of the primary coil is critical. Means clamping or rigidly, we need to rigidly clamp the primary coil, which is critical of task. Shorter life of the coil due to the large force acting on it. As due to the magnetic pressure is hundreds of megapascal, due to this the life of the coil is short in this process. So these are the some disadvantages of this process. What are the application of this process? Electromagnetic forming process is capable for a wide variety of forming and assembly operation. It is used for a wide variety of application and it is widely used. Bending of the tubes into the complex shape. The tubes can be bent easily in a complex shape. Blugging of the thin tubes can be easily blugged. It has a found extensive application in a fabrication of hollow, non-circular or asymmetrical shape from the tubular stock. From the tubular stock, if we want to produce a circular, hollow, non-circular, hollow and asymmetrical shape, it can be easily formed. Flat coil has been used on a flat sheet to produce the stretch. Electromagnetic forming also be used to perform the shearing, pitching and riveting operation. To perform this type of the operation, this electromagnetic forming will be used. Okay, so these are the some references. So it is enough for today's session. In today's session, we have discussed that electro hydraulic forming and electromagnetic forming, in which we discuss that the introduction of these processes. Then what is the principle behind this process? What are the process parameter which will affects on this process? Then what are the principle? Then what is the advantages of this process? What are the disadvantages of this process? And what are the application of this process? Okay. So it is enough for today's session. The next part will be discussed in a next lecture. Thank you.